Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So those of you who are here for the first time, I'm a lawyer in Ontario, Canada, and I vlog about general advice about legal market and about general market. Like today I'm going to give you practical tips of finding job in Canada, which I think are very useful, very practical, and if you incorporate them, then I'm sure they're going to help you. Secondly guys, I have opened up an Instagram page, you can see the link here. And you can also know that I'm going to discuss about immigration and refugee and human rights law of Canada in that vlog. I think that's a very useful topic and people are being frauded and scammed, but that is very sad state of affairs. And I think that it's my domain, right? I am an immigrant myself and I like to discuss immigration law. In fact, I deal with immigration clients all the time. So I just want to make sure that the information that is going out there is authentic, at least, you know, people take their decisions with due diligence. So this is the link on Instagram which you can see, and any vlogs which I'm going to make, I have categorized my playlist. So if you go into my videos and you see the playlist, I have made different series. So whatever series is of your interest, you go and watch that, because I will vlog about multiple things, right? You might not want to see all of that, you might want to see all of that, then, but you just need to go in that particular, it's organized like my files, so you can go and check that out. The first tip is that when you are looking out for a job, what ideally you should do is, and the approach should be, that you should do a job market strategy study. So this is a very good strategy to start approaching the job market. Some people just get out of their degree, you know, jump into the job market without knowing that what thing they are bringing on the table. Even if they are freshers, you have to start from somewhere, I understand. But if you do a strategy market study, which is strategic, I am sure it's going to help you. So for lawyers, I say, for example, now I should know that what is happening in COVID and what kind of area of law is going to be hit and what kind of area of law is going to, you know, have a boom. So according to that research, for the lawyers who are listening to me, the trial lawyers are seriously hit in Canada, and the lawyers like the in-house counsels and contracts and insolvency laws are still on a safer side. But what I do meant to say is that keep doing your strategy study, know about the market that you're targeting, your field is, you know, whatever you think is sufficient, research, and only then come to a good conclusion so that you know what you're looking at. So guys, one more tip I think which is very useful for people who are migrants or who are looking for a job in Canada right now is that even though you have worked in a multi-millionaire company, but what you need to understand that even if you were at that level, you can start from a smaller firm. Do not assume that people are going to have the same pay brackets. Maybe some smaller firms pay more than the bigger firms. The exposure of a smaller firm, you can't even imagine it. And the work you do and what kind of impact you create, it is so related. Like you can really relate to in a small firm, in a boutique firm, or in a small company. Why do I say that? Because your each and every effort would be counted. Whereas in a big firm, your work is just like one mug in the whole river, so it might just not be counted. So why not, you know, target the smaller firms and not always go for the big firms? It is okay to start small and then maybe head your way up. Sometimes even people, what they do is they learn so much from the small firms that it becomes like their baby product, and they, you know, put all their lives in that small firm and make it a bigger firm. So I think you should always keep your mind open to all things, especially when you're immigrants in Canada. Your horizon should be wide open. You should be open to opportunities and not restrict yourself when it comes to work. So guys, my another tip is that when you're targeting the job market, you make sure you target it to the best websites. So there is Glassdoor, there is LinkedIn. LinkedIn is apparently a very good website to find jobs in Canada. Then also is Indeed. Indeed is also a very good platform to find a job in Canada. So these are the legal websites I can share in the description box. But those who are listening who are not lawyers and in general looking out for jobs in Canada, then you should probably just look around in your field and research that what kind of domain is very good, which website is very good for you to research. So what happens is that if you do not be selective with your website approach and your approach is not right, then sometimes maybe you miss a very good opportunity which was only listed. Employers only list certain jobs in these kind of high-end websites. So not every job is listed everywhere. You might not want to miss that opportunity, and keep yourself and your resume updated with these kind of websites. I think this is a very important tip, that you should have a futuristic approach. And how will you do that? Now, do not, when you are an immigrant in Canada or when you are looking for a job in Canada, do not worry about what people will say, how people will react. No, I always say a big no to this. don't hesitate to go and search about a specific individual. Like in my area of practice, I really followed cybersecurity law, humanitarian law, and immigration and refugee law. These were my areas of key inclination, right? So I used to go and find people in the big firms, and you know, amid this COVID thing also, I used to just send them a LinkedIn message or a mail or anything. I just used to be upfront in approach without having any specific kind of intention in mind, just with the intention of networking and knowing people and having mentors here. People who shape you. You do not always need to have some kind of, you know, taking intention. Always have the giving intention, and the universe is so that it will give you back. Okay guys, honestly tell me, when you're looking for a job and when you have applied for a job and when you called for an interview, or even if you're not called for an interview, how many of you have actually gone into the company's details, firm's details, and tried to see what the true picture of the firm is, how their culture is, whatever it is. These are the points which will help you have a conversation with one of the players in that team, right? So you should always be very much prepared. Now, supposedly there was a LinkedIn study which I was going through, and in that study many people were asked that, are you prepared to meet your dream employer tomorrow? 90 people plus people were blank. They were like, no, we need to prepare about what we're going to say there. So make sure you're prepared. Preparation is the key for everything, even for a job interview, even for an informational interview, like a rough chit chat or anything. You should have you should have that kind of capability to hold a conversation. And how will you have that when you impress somebody? And how will you impress somebody when you tell them that yes, you are really interested and you know about their company and firm? Guys, a lot of time I also suggest everybody to cold call in Canada. What happens? What will happen? What worse will happen? They will just say, no, you are not required. We do not have a position. And sorry, but that's it. इससे ज़्यादा कुछ नहीं होगा, तो इतना डरने की ज़रूरत नहीं होती है. Open Google, call your kind of firms and just ask them if you can come on basic wages, if you can start with basic, maybe you just want to learn the work, you are a new immigrant. Try and put an emotional appeal across cold calling. You never know. I swear to God, you never know when they might hire you and when they might call you for a volunteer position maybe. And you do not want to miss that in a company where you've been calling and you had a dream to work, right? Because nobody in Canada will keep you for free for a very long time. So they all know that they need to pay, and they have this basic employment obligation on their head always. So try and cold call people, right? And especially now when everything is going virtual and database, so why wouldn't you take that chance when you can just send an email or maybe connect on LinkedIn? But never approach the person, like never approach an employer or an HR or anybody in that particular firm, you know, who's at a position where he can influence the decision. Never just go and say that, okay, I'm looking for this, my qualification is this, can you help me? Why would, if I am an employer, why would I try to help anybody like that? I wouldn't. Why would I? I would rather know the person, know the credibility of that person, see the why that person is good, and only then would I want to recruit that person. So do you get my point? You do not bombard the employer and go with that intention. They can make it out. But what you should do is you should network and you should approach with a very easy approach, not a very greedy approach, right? So keep that in mind. As an immigrant, I have told this in my earlier vlogs also to all the lawyers out there, that try and discount your foreign experience. See, I know you've been working really hard in your home countries, but what I do want you to understand is that you are a new immigrant in this country, and there are people who are living already in this country who sustain on this economy and everything. So you need to keep that in mind. Nobody minds here to go for a job which is under your credentials or to make your CV look like that. So for example, I have done 10 years of maybe experience, and if my 10 years of experience on my CV, I'm trying to buy a sales job, then I probably won't even get that. But you need that job because you need to survive in Canada in the initial start, right? So you need to tailor your CV and you need to discount your foreign experience. And how will you do that? When you try and be humble in this country. Just try and be humble and down to earth in this country, and just try to be with a smile, because you know Canadians love to smile. Just with a smile approach any kind of job, every kind of job, and just be open that way. But do not think that your foreign experience is going to get you magical wand here. No, you have to discount your foreign experience in order to step by step climb the Canadian economy. Tip I really want to share with you guys, and it is very crucial and very interesting. Now this lady, she's a LinkedIn connection manager. I was reading her interview and she says that one of the tips to find a job is embrace the humble brag. Now what do I mean by embrace the humble brag? What I mean is, now you are going to be giving interviews. So what if you are not selected in one interview? So what if you're not selected in two interviews? You're eventually going to make it. But what is also essential that you need to know is that you are gaining the experience of giving interviews. Now this female here, she says that what you have to do as an exercise is tell your loved ones, your spouse, your kids, your mother, father, whoever it is in your family, friends and family, ask them to write what they like about you. Now, once they have written what they like about you, you know those are your selling points, and try to sell them in your LinkedIn profile, maybe in your interview, in your informational interviews. Just try to sell those points, because see, it is not about bragging about something, it is a humble brag. Why is it a humble brag? Because these are your good points, and these are going to fetch you some kind of unique identity. So try and expose them to your employer or your recruiter, and I am sure that you're going to get there. So one last tip is that I often tell this, that how many of us are really prepared to walk through that door right now? I don't think so you are. I don't think so I would be. If given an opportunity, I would have to. Then no, we have to be prepared before, you know, the final nail in the coffin. So how do we do that? We do that when we read about our subject, read about the job market, and when we personalize and when we network with the intention of finding a job. Maybe deep down in our hearts, obviously, we do want some kind of favor. After all, we're humans. But we also need to understand that we need to personalize. We need to have a personalized touch to all of it. Even if it is your cover letter, if it is your CV, if it is tailored according to the companies and the person who's your network, according to his his mindset, then I am sure you are above a lot many applicants. So keep this in mind, that you give a personalized touch. So even if you are done with an interview, send a thank you note, because that shows, okay, you thought it through. But send a thank you note after 24 hours or maybe 48 hours. Network as much as you can, but do network without an intention of getting immediate results. You might get results, but within a span of some time. Just be patient. So guys, I hope all of these tips were useful for you all. Now that I'm going to say bye to all of you and going to say all the best. Do not worry, in the COVID times, when this gets over, I don't know how the market is going to be. It is after Corona and before Corona, so it can be AC and BC, but we do not know what is going to happen. For now, what I do know is that the legal market is really affected, and it is one of the professions which is going to be hardest hit. And also guys, if you want to follow more for my informational and my legal blogs, do follow me on Instagram at this, and then you will know that I also, you know, share my legal knowledge with you guys. But anything that I say and do is not legal advice, keep that in mind. That's always a disclaimer in my description box. So if you want me to blog about any such more informational topics which you think would help you find a job in Canada, do let me know in the comment section, and I will be waiting, and I try and respond to all of them. If anyone is left out, then I'm so sorry, but I will surely reach you. And don't you forget to like, subscribe and share my video.